feel safer. Astronaut, I move solo cause it feels fake friends and fake people. Some of them is hate. Fake friends and fake people. Some of them is haters.
Hello, what's going on? Welcome to Spc3lnd. We're here. This is my official walk around of my 1989 Honda Civic, better known as the EF Civic Sedan. I have the LX version. Really was no difference between the DX and the LX per se. It was mostly features. I mean, the engine was the same, the D15 V2. In my opinion, one of the slowest engines that Honda's ever made. But it was more known, for its fuel economy. So, you know, overall, I mean, it is what it is. I bought the car back like in February, of this year. I bought it. It was at first I was buying it. I had another sedan. I had a DX, a 90 DX. Wound up selling it, but overall I bought this car because it was running, but there was no title. So my intent was to swap out everything off of this car and put it into the DX. Wound up selling the DX. Then the guy emailed me back saying, you know, he had the title, he found the title again. So with that, he messaged me back and I wound up buying, and this became the Civic that I now have. So when I first got the Civic, when I first was my first drive ever, right? When I first bought the car and drove it from Richmond, you know, when I was reading the ad, he was saying that it was a grinding noise if you put it in gear. But he said everything ran, everything was good. So I was like, yo, I might as well just drive it home for the hour and a half or whatever and get a feel for the car, you know, at least, you know, because from the way I was feeling, you know, being that I wasn't that far and the car had
damn high
mileage,
son,
and, you know, with Hondas, to my knowledge, from what people say, you can sometimes, you never really know what happened to the car in the past, so it's like everything is like inevitable, you know what I'm saying? So I was like, if anything is going to happen, this engine blow, this transmission go, it's going to happen anyway. And I'm going to keep the car anyway. So I'm like, yo, I'm going to drive it home. So I got an extra plate, you know what I'm saying? And I said, I'm going to drive it at night. I'm going to drive it home. We're going to see what happens. You know what I'm saying? The car driving strong. Like, you heard the grinding noise, but I don't know. It just wasn't affecting the drivability of the car. Like, I could put it in gear. You know, I was testing out the clutch to see if it was, the clutch was good. I mean, I know I'm going to have to probably replace it, but I'm like, yo, this car works fine for what it is right now, which was a daily driver. Because obviously, I'm not going to go and just slap a turbo on it. Or even if I'm even sure, I still want to go with a D-series build. You know what I'm saying? So I was like, right now, I could just drive the car, get a feel for it, and, you know, try to work on everything else. So, like, you know, driving the car home, getting a look at it, it's a solid buy. Like, yo, it got power mirrors.
Dang.
It got the power windows. Dang. It got the automatic windows, which I thought was crazy. Like, for it to be an 89, I'm like, damn. Like, I don't even, you know what I'm saying? I don't got that handle shit. I got the button, like, but the motors were kind of fucked up. So I just went, like, I just said the rear window motors, I guess, are out. So they don't really work, but I'm like, you know, I'm basically going to use this car for Instacart and, like, food sharing. So I don't intend to have people in the backseat anyway. You know what I'm saying? So fuck those windows. There's no cracks in the dash. There's no cracks in the door panels. You know, the seats are filthy. The carpet's filthy. It just seems like it's more cosmetic than anything. The bumpers are faded. The paint's all rusted. You know, other than that, the car seems solid. Weird things that I want to point out, like the D15 V2 is super fucking slow. It's terrible. fuel economy based engine. I'm pretty sure that's what they made it for, but God, like, it's such a difference from driving my ST and then driving this, you know. So I definitely want turbo. I definitely want that feel. But like, what else? Shoot, the radio is broke. It came with the OEM radio. Came with a lot of OEM stuff. Nothing was really done to the car. Like, he switched out a bulb or two. Like, I know the front bulb, you can't see it now because it's daytime, but it has like a LED on one side. The license plate bulbs are LED. You know, that regular stuff. But like, it's no suspension upgrades, no engine upgrades, no nothing. Like, this car is like bone stock. But yeah, it drive good and everything. Like, it's cosmetic, you know. So far right now, I want to go with a D series build, because it has the most potential and the least respect. Like, I feel like people will be jumping to B series and K series and even H series. And I'm personally, from what I've seen, like, as far as dropping in H series in the cars, like, it just seems like it's mad complicated. But people go to that before I feel like they go to the D series, because I mean, the engines are slow, but you can build them to make them fast. I feel like my goal, I want to get at least 180 out of this joint for it to be just a car to use Instacart and Postmates and whatever. Like, I think that's fair. I think that's, you know, fast enough. Like, I think, you know, for the car that had been sitting for a year and where it's at now, I think it'll do just fine. So, you know, I'm gonna plan that out, see what's next. But I definitely know for a fact I want to get the suspension worked on first. I want to work on the suspension. I want to get some rear brakes, because these come with the rear hubs and the front brakes only. What else? I want to get the brakes done. I'm definitely, like, I'd replace it. If I'd stick with the D series and I don't pull the whole engine, which I'm most likely going to not do, like, I'm most likely going to stick with the D series, I'm going to just replace the transmission. I'm going to probably do, like, a mini-me build or something.
Showed you guys the Civic, you know what I'm saying. As far as I'm concerned, my goal is going to be the either a built D15 or a built D16. Either way, I'm trying to go for the low boost. I kind of wanted to, like I said, stay in this area, because this is, you know, I'm entry level to the Honda game. You know, like I said, I've been dealing with Fords and a couple other things, but I've never really messed with Honda. So for me, it'll be a cheap build. I'm gonna buy most of the stuff off eBay. You're gonna see. Obviously, I'm not trying to say to go the cheap route, but the market is so big that it's like, you know, you have selections of everything. You know what I'm saying? So with it being an entry build, I might as well go the cheap way, work my way up, and as things, you know, when I need to start getting reasonable shit, or if I have to, like, obviously the pistons and rods, I'm gonna get a legit set. You know what I'm saying? It's gonna be fun. We're gonna see what's going on. You know, my next step pretty much is to do. I bought a couple of parts. As I've seen, shown you the brakes. I found a couple of do-it-yourself mods that I was gonna do. Show y'all that. And just keep going forward. Again, and after that, I'm probably gonna work on suspension. You know, I gotta get a clutch. You remember the grinding noise? I gotta replace that. So it's a couple things I'm gonna do. And I gotta, you know, I'm gonna just try to show you everything that's going on. We try to, you know, put everything under the camera, because like I said, I'm having fun with this car, so I'm pretty sure that the end result is going to be even better. So just stay tuned. If you haven't, like and subscribe, and just, you know, saying, just follow me. Word up.
Because the bread important, I go hard. Because the bread important, I go hard.